Straight up chill mode. I'm laying back in my bed, just chilling, doing things. Laying back in my bed, relaxing, having a good old time.
So grim about the homestead now that Miss Abigail and little Connor have passed.
Aye, I've seen Achilles crying.
Why shouldn't he?
It's just that he doesn't look sad. He looks furious. It's unsettling.
He's struggling with the loss. We all are.
I know, but it's been months, and we've done little but search for this blasted manuscript and box.
Le Chasseur has a lead on the box. To meet him and Chevalier in St. John's.
Chevalier too? No hope of cheering me up then.
Old skipper, you cannot.
When Achilles said whoever had the artifacts could access sites of great power, what did he mean?
I'm not sure I understand it myself, Shay. I had a long talk with Adewale about that. He believes the box can be activated to, well, project words. Or images.
Like a magic lantern.
What do you mean?
You know the magic lantern shows Father Connolly put on in the church basement? The box had a candle in it, I think. He put these little glass plates in front. Then we'd see the images projected on the wall like cathedrals in Rome. Bright and near as big as life.
Ah, yeah. I suppose it is. Except that it interprets a strange language of the manuscript, too. If the plate were of a banner in Latin, we'd see it in English.
How is that possible?
Who knows? I fear we might never truly understand how any of the pieces of Eden work.
Where in the world has the most beautiful girls?
I suppose it depends on your vision of beauty. A damsel from Corfu and one from Oslo are as different as chalk and cheese, but both could be lovely.
See, opinions like that give a man a reputation for wisdom.
Yeah, thank you.
I would have just said Havana. The girls there have lusty buttocks and bosoms and feel no shame in putting them on display. But that's no slight against our lasses from home.
Oh, what ice. Whoops.
I think Galway has the nicest ones. Fair and modest. Always willing to spot you a penny for an ale.
We're almost there, Captain. Le Chasseur will be expecting us.
And Chevalier.
At a small price to pay for a lead in the precursor box.
Sir, to four!
Reef the topsails and gallants! Chevalier, what happened to your vessel?
I got myself into a bit of a scrape. Sent three ship in all hand to their watery grave. The Gaffo nearly followed them down.
Just your fate has been better, Le Chasseur.
Indeed. My sources inform me that Samuel Smith has searched far and wide, looking for answers on how to make that strange box work. He just returned from Europe.
Where is he now?
Refitting his schooner. If you hurry. You can catch him there.
Oh,
Remember those blueprints? Well, I had an engineer build that marvelous weapon for your ship. Master Buckle's gun fires more shots than an artillery brigade, and twice as fast.
Many thanks.
Anything for my hooded friends.
Captain?
I will join you on this voyage.
Then shall we, gentlemen?
You are in a jovial mood, Shay.
Why shouldn't I be? I have a new weapon, and will soon have a chance to use it. Besides, Templars are usually well guarded, and I'm sure that Smith fellow is no exception.
I also took the liberty of ordering some improvements. Morgan now has a ram to cut through ice itself.
I have heard of such technology, but never witnessed its operation.
What about Smith, then? Is he close by?
Aye. He sails these very waters.
There he is. Most fortunate
he may
timing.
Have the precursor box.
Lady Luck never ceases to smile on you.
He's seen us. Give chase.
But hold your fire. We must not damage the box or risk losing it to the sea. Can't this blockade go any faster?
At least my ship is still seaworthy, Chevalier.
Our target's a smart man, but out of his own.
What he's doing in these waters is beyond me.
Maybe he came here to meet someone, or ran into your pirates. He's refitting his ship. Something must have happened.
If one of my allies attacked him, I would have known about it.
When he's back from a long voyage, a chance to get him.
He controls most of the Templars well, doesn't he? Him out of the way.
Washington entrusted the precursor box to him. He probably still has it.
Shay's right. The box comes first.
So we can't sink him. We'll have to board his ship. We'll force him to beach.
Careful, Captain. He could fire many bombs.
Look, Captain. He's cutting through the ice.
It seems you are not the only one equipped with such a ram, Shay.
Let us hope ours fares just as well.
Worked. The way is clear.
Now, once more, your fortune holds. But do not waste time congratulating yourself. Smith is getting away.
Taking care of that ice sheet.
The fog controls these waters closely, Captain. It's an ambush.
Halfway you see, Diablo not there. Smith must not escape.
Take it!
They're
don't see Smith's ship.
Let's get rid of these distractions first. We'll find him. He's still within reach.
Aboard, Captain!
Come on, come on, come on, come on.
What wickedness is this?
Another Templar tactic. You can cover whole stretches of ocean with their flames.
Careful, Shay. We could be burnt to cinders.
It's nothing more than a last desperate throw of the dice. He knows we have him.
Now we know where he was headed. Barsad has an encampment here.
Follow him on land. Do not even think of firing the ship's weapons near that precious box.
I'll take care of this.
We're losing ground.
Dead in sight.
Corner him.
Fish in a barrel, mate.
Got him. Let's go.
This cannot be. No. Do you even know what that is?
An ancient artifact. Treasure from those who came before.
Yes. It matters not. Some of the greatest scientific minds of all Europe could not make it work.
Now all I need is the manuscript, and all shall be revealed.
Thank you. Oh, that wasn't nice. What kind of loot you gonna give me is what I wonder. Hopes were high for a win that day. Go meet Party Boys, bro.
I've got the precursor box. It's dead.
Well done, Che.
Where's Chevalier?
We're turning to Ligure 4. We'll have to celebrate without him, I'm afraid.
I don't much feel like celebrating, Liam. I know we have to get these artifacts back, but at what cost? Samuel Smith. He could barely hold his sword straight. Killing him was
necessary.
What?
But nothing. Smith was a dangerous man. Templar. What's worse, he had the precursor box. You should be proud of yourself, Shane.
Perhaps.
We should head for Albany now. James Wardle, the fellow Lawrence Washington gave the manuscript to reveal. Sigurd Watson reported that James Wardle looted out many tribes from their ancestral lands. We have proof that he's one of the countless massacres. He's one of the most devious and ruthless men in the colonies.
He uses the letter of the law to serve his purposes. When the law does not bend to him, he gets lawmakers to bend it for him. Mark my words, Shay. James Roger is a bureaucrat. He doesn't care how his actions affect others. It's the same old song. Get up, Jack John, sit down.
Her way through!
Got it.
down! Catch some wind!
Loose sail! Put out all she'll take!
Almost there.
Better.
You!
You must have something to hide. Someone should go after him. You won't lose us. You're already dead.
We the people.
You're here. Congress is still in session. George Washington and his militia have fired on French troops under Jumonville. The French are calling it an act of war.
George Washington. You mean Lawrence's younger brother?
Yeah, it's the same. Speaking of Lawrence Washington, you eliminated him. James Wardrop has moved up in ranks. All the Templar resources are at his disposal now.
What about the manuscript?
My sources in New York confirm that Wardrop has it. I also learned that he is here at the Congress under heavy guard.
Shay, find Wardrop. Get that manuscript.
This place is thick with Templar troops. Liam and I will make sure he doesn't escape.
Sneak into the Albany Congress.
You! Stop!
Was Colonel of the Warriors of the Six Nations for a while. He's responsible for New York levies, I think. He looks still fighting all over the Congress.
Maybe we can get some decent food.
That must be the Templar William Johnson. Perhaps he has the manuscript, or knows where it is.
As I have stated previously, I believe we need a national union, granted by an act of parliament, but bringing greater independence to our colonies. The French are an immediate threat, and we are ill prepared to face them. To put it bluntly, the colonies must join or die.
A rousing speech, Master Franklin. But do you truly believe Great Britain will grant her colonies autonomy?
They have little choice, Master Johnson. You know the remoteness of this frontier better than most.
Yes. But let us leave politics for another day. I wanted to thank you for your research.
Of course. Of course. In the brief time I could examine that box, I could tell it was something unique. From ancient Egypt, you said? Well, as I mentioned in my letter, I am quite ready to electrify it.
Excellent. We will have the box delivered shortly. As for the manuscript, Captain?
I apologize, sir, but Master Wardrop refused to hand it over. He said the risks were too great.
The risks? Ah. I apologize. You will have the manuscript and the box in the briefest of delays.
Humane excuse for a uniform. Run to Fort Frederick and tell Master Wardrop he had better cough up the manuscript post-haste. Else I will have him scalped.
I can't let that lobster captain reach Wardrop.
Suppose it depends on King George. I think we need a problem.
Shoot.
I can't let that lobster captain reach Wardrop.
Suppose it depends on King George.
I think we need a stronger colonial government, with or without it.
To Wardrop and the manuscript.
Let's go. Found him.
there! Stop!
Take that, you Templar dog.
No! You have no idea what you're doing, fool!
Keeping the people free from your control.
How free will you be when the French undermine these squabbling colonies?
These colonies would be far better off without the Templars pulling the strings.
We bring order from chaos. If everything is permitted, no one is safe.
Even the devil can quote scripture to suit his own purposes.
You give us the slip, maggot!
I have the manuscript.
Great. Hope is waiting for you in Sleepy Hollow.
What's in Sleepy Hollow?
Benjamin Franklin. Man Johnson hired to make that strange precursor box work.
So what's the plan?
Meet Hope. Personate one of Johnson's men. And give the box and manuscript to Franklin.
So I'm a messenger then.
See if this Franklin can figure out how this damn box operates. Stay with him. Oh, as far as we can tell, this man doesn't know about the Templars or the assassins for that matter.
Oh, a simple task.
For a simple man.
One evening in July, I met a mate who has betrayed in a sale at Johnson. I had it so away, you sent it, my dear Annie. Oh, you New York girls, can't you dance a polka? To Tiffany's I took her, I did not mind expense. I bought her two gold earrings, and they cost me 50 cents. And it's away, you sent it. Oh, you do your girls can't
get ahead, sir!
Says she, yet I'm you sailor. Now see me home, you may.
Cargo,
but when
the
we
grip,
reach
Captain.
The cottage door, she and to
that's the royals at the top!
Turn
it off! Destination top! Unfurled maids! Let's move!
Oh, you do your girls can't you dance the poker. My freshman, he's
get
the
them aloft! That's all same!
We're late. The sky is getting temperamental.
That's not the only thing, is it? Master Franklin, sir. My name is Shay, and this is my associate Hope. William Johnson told us to give you these.
Oh. Thank you, but I'm afraid I must delay my experiment.
Delay it? Why?
The army confiscated my lightning rods. They are essential to conducting the electricity. I need to vivify your box.
Master Johnson would not want you to have to wait.
Perhaps there is something you can do, then. Soldiers have been hauling things away all day. Perhaps they could tell you where they've taken my lightning rods so you could get them back.
At your service, sir.
Begin your investigation at the market near the docks. I will stay here and help with the preparations.
This is intolerable.